This Sunday edition of WeatherScope is sponsored by Midas Auto Systems Experts. What can we do for you today?
This is WeatherScope.
A massive storm system is sitting over two-thirds of the nation today, causing a variety of severe weather, ranging from severe thunderstorms, flooding rain, and blizzard conditions. Good afternoon, this Sunday afternoon. Welcome to this edition of WeatherScope. I'm Lisa Moser. Again today, parts of the southeast are the target for some stormy weather. Bob Stokes has been monitoring the situation and joins us from the Forecast Center. Bob?
Thanks a lot, Lisa. When you combine a cold front with subtropical air, you've got a volatile atmosphere shaping up, and that's what's occurring now in the southeastern part of the country, where we have tornado watches as well as individual warnings and even tornado warnings, which we're going to talk about in a moment. We're going to assess some damage that's been occurring due to flooding. But first, let's take a look now at the current map. There's the cold front moving toward the east, the subtropical flow coming in. There's the leading edge of that warm air. In fact, this is the warm sector of the storm system, the actual low here pulling off toward the northeast. As it does so, the moisture keeps coming in from the Gulf of Mexico, and as these open spaces continue to appear, enough sunshine could create more instability in the atmosphere. In fact, we have two tornado watches in effect, covering a good chunk of southern Alabama, southern Georgia, and the panhandle of Florida. The yellow represents a severe thunderstorm watch in effect, so you need to be careful and may want to postpone traveling in those areas. We have a tornado warning as well in Clarendon County, South Carolina. Let's go to South Carolina on the radar picture, and you can see right here, Clarendon County is included right there just to the south of Sumter, South Carolina. Now, the word on that is the National Weather Service radar did indicate a likely tornado 5 miles to the east of Santee near Lake Marion. Movement is toward the northeast at 40 miles per hour. Seek shelter. Go to a low-lying place in your home, an interior room like a closet, and for example, your basement, because this is a dangerous thunderstorm cell. Rain has been heavy across the southeast. Yesterday it was coming down. Some rainfalls have exceeded 11 inches. In Atlanta, we got about 3 inches in the capital of Georgia, and it fell in a very short period of time. The quickly falling precipitation did its work to flood low-lying areas in the city. If you are in a traditionally flood-prone area, expect to have high water hazards today. We've seen major damage in terms of flooding and even death and injury due to very heavy rains in Alabama. I believe Scott Adcock, public information officer of the Alabama Emergency Management Agency, is on the line. Scott, are you with me?
Yes, Yes, I'm with you, Bob.
Scott, could you describe, please, the problems you're facing now in Alabama?
Well, we have numerous problems in southeast Alabama because of the heavy rainfall that began yesterday. Our State Emergency Operations Center has been activated since yesterday. Governor Fob James issued a state of emergency. Because of the flooding conditions that are occurring in South Alabama, we have Alabama National Guard missions that are in place and have been occurring. Flood prevention measures are underway. Also, military police support for security and traffic control support. Also, sandbagging measures have been underway. We have state emergency management agency staff in local emergency operations centers working with local emergency management agencies to coordinate their request for state assistance. The biggest problem that we have right now is in the city of Elba. As you remember, 8 years ago, almost to the day, this month back in 1990, the levees broke in Elba, and the city was flooded. We've got the same type of situation occurring now. Evacuations have been ongoing. Unfortunately, there is one fatality that's been reported this morning, and also one person missing. We had two breaks in the levee around Elba. And the city is somewhere around 4 to 6 feet now flooded.
Well, Scott, thank you very much, and thank you for being on top of the situation, and we appreciate that report. The rainfall has been heavy not only in Alabama but along the Gulf Coast. Mississippi, for example, in Biloxi, look at this amount, just under 11.5 inches of rainfall in Biloxi. Atlanta has seen just under 3 inches of rainfall due to that subtropical flow coming in. You see it there wrapping around the low. More is on the way as the system generally pulls off toward the northeast, so the rain is not over. A lot of it focused now in the southeastern part of the country. We told you about the tornado warning in Clarendon County, South Carolina. Also, we have rough weather, say, south of Atlanta, getting into the southeastern part of Alabama. Lightning hazard, as well as gusty winds. That same system affecting the Carolinas and getting down into the Augusta, Georgia area. So a very volatile situation as the southeastern part of the country is looking very rough this afternoon. Stay here on the Weather Channel, but if you have to leave your TV set, you can get updated on all the weather, including the blizzard in the Midwest, at weather.com. Speaking of that blizzard, let's join Lisa Moser in the studio.
Thanks, Bob. Bob Stokes, standing by in the Forecast Center, will continue to update us this afternoon on that very stormy situation in the southeast. Snow is the other factor, as Bob mentioned, sprawling a storm system, and we are looking at what this system is capable of producing. Certainly, blizzard.